Hi there, this is Paula from Replicon, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use Replicon's CloudClock. A CloudClock is a tablet device that acts as a time clock. You use the CloudClock to punch in and out for your shifts and breaks, and, if you use them, projects, tasks, and activities. The CloudClock is linked to your organization's Replicon system for easy tracking of the hours you worked. The hours you record may then be used for various things, such as generating your pay. Before you can create a punch with a CloudClock, you need to log into it. There are three methods for logging in: using a QR card, entering your user ID, or by facial recognition. Your administrator has chosen which of these methods you can use. You may even be allowed to use more than one of the methods. If you were given a QR card, hold it up to the screen to scan the code located on it. If you're using facial recognition, position yourself so your face is visible on the screen. Or simply enter the user ID your supervisor gave you in the field provided. If a secondary method is available, click the button at the bottom of the screen to switch to that method. Once logged in, you'll have 10 seconds to create a punch or take some other action. If you miss this window, you'll need to log in again. You'll need to punch in and out when you start and end each shift, based on your assigned schedule. With every punch, the clock will take a picture of you to add to your punch audit trail, so your supervisor knows it was actually you who made the punch. So be sure your face is visible in the circle when you make your punches. To punch in, tap the Clock In button. A confirmation screen will display and the clock will start recording your work hours. Note that if you work on projects, tasks, or activities, you may need to use the CloudClock to record your hours against those items. Before punching, tap to select the item you want to punch against. You may be able to filter tasks by a client name. Note that you can't choose a billing rate. Your default rate will be assigned. To punch out, log in again and tap Clock Out. You should only need to punch out at the end of your shift. Note that you may see some additional fields above punch buttons. These are custom fields you can complete before punching. If you need to change which task or activity you're working on, click Transfer. Your hours will be recorded under the new task you select, and an out time will be automatically added to the in punch you created for the previous project, task, or activity. And when you take a break, log in and tap the break button. When your break is complete, tap resume work. You'll be given the option to change tasks if applicable. Finally, try to punch in and out as close to your scheduled start and end times as possible to ensure you are paid correctly. You can check that your hours were recorded correctly by logging into the CloudClock, tapping the menu icon in the top left-hand corner of the clock, and then tapping Timesheet. Your current timesheet displays by default, but you can tap the date arrow to view other timesheets. Tap a day to view punches for that day. Data for that day displays here. Note that rounded values for punches are saved here, if applicable. Rarely, users are given permission to edit their own punches or even add missing punches. Most users cannot modify punches. So if you find an error, talk to your supervisor. They can probably correct it for you. And that's about all you need to get started using CloudClock. If you have questions, be sure to talk to your supervisor. That's all from me for now. Thanks for your time.